this tutorial, I will show you how to write the regulation strategy of a simple temperature control loop. Since I like the teach and learn by doing, we can start immediately our first exercise. These are the requirement specification of the exercise. We will compare the water inlet temperature that we will read from the analog input number 1 with a set point and a proportional band in order to create a proportional signal from 0% to 100%. Based on this, there are the four stages for the four compressors that will drive the digital output, that is the relay number 1, 2, 3 and 4. So the first compressor will start at 25% of the proportional band, the second 50%, 75% and 100%. Let's start creating a new project. We can start from scratch, that is an empty project, or from a template. For this exercise, I prefer to start from scratch, so I will select empty project. Anyway, starting from the exercise regarding alarms, we will use the template. So I give a name, chiller, I will select a path, I will save it in the C root folder. Okay, and the system creates in the Solution Explorer the view on the parts of the application. The content of the Solution Explorer depends on the software model of the standard IEC 61131. Here below you can find the definition of what there is inside the schema. Anyway, at first level there is the configuration that basically in our system corresponds to a CPICO. A configuration can contain one or more resources. In our system is a CPU. A resource can run one or more tasks that runs programs or function or function block. Program, function or function block are called POU, Program Organization Unit, that basically are just a part or a subroutine of the program. In C Suite we can have only one project for a given solution, one or more devices per project and only one resource per device. For this reason it is possible to simplify this view selecting the project name and then the S button. The result is this, so we can hide the device, resource and lib. In this way the tree becomes flat like this, so easier to read. And then there is the data type node. In the data type node, it is possible to create the derived data type. The derived data type are the array. The system supports also multidimensional array, as you can see here. The structures. In this example, we can see a structure of two, and based on two elementary data type, two boolean. But you can create a structure of structure like this example. At the end we have the defined word. In the environment supporting the textual declaration, these are the variable constant. In the other side we have the elementary data type. As told in the introduction, C-Suite support all the data types of the standard IEC 61131 up to the 32-bit, included the double integer, signed and unsigned, and real. A significant difference compared to one tool is that in C Suite all these data types can be used in all the editors. In the strategy editor, user interface editor, input-output editor, protocols, logs, and so on. At the moment the only restriction regards the time and date and string that can be used only in C strategy. Device resource, in the program we can create the program's POU, basically it is the main of the application. Here we can add, that is create, pages, but the exact name is POU, of any of these four languages: sequential function chart, structured text, ladder, function block diagram. And you can mix them without any restriction. So we can use the ideal the more suitable language according to the strategy that we have to write. In the first exercise, we will use only FBD. So we can create a new POU FBD. Let's rename temperature regulation. Next item is global variables. Global variables correspond more or less to the variable list in Mimon tool, and here we can create, of course, the new variables. Next is the libnode, where we can create function and function blocks. They correspond, also in this case, more or less to the macro blocks in Mimon tool. The last is alarms, that is a specific editor for the alarms, but we will see this in another tutorial. So let's start to write our exercise. So the first thing that we have to do is create a proportional signal from 0 to 100% according to the set point and the proportional band. So what we need is a block called conv. So let's reopen the page. Now, before to continue, we can reset the layout of the windows so we can use the same windows in the same position. So we are talking about the blocks. For this we have to use a block called conv. Where are the blocks here? The blocks are in a window called block library. It is not visible, so we have to open it. Block library, we move it here in the bottom. You can see that a new project comes with two default library, the standard and the Karel Pico. Standard corresponds more or less to the Atoms library in one tool, that is, it contains the very basic function like arithmetic operator, comparator, basic timers, converter, and so on. While the Karel Pico contains function that are peculiar of the Karel Pico. So let's search for the conv. Conv is not here and also not here. In fact, it is in another library that is called Karel Basic Lib that we have to add here in the Solution Explorer. So we have to right click the project name, chiller, add dependency. This is the list of the libraries that I have installed in my PC. Of course, I will select the newest one. And now I have to reopen the page, block library. Oh, it's empty. Why is empty? Because we have to click an FBD page. Here are the libraries, so I will collapse the. Okay, I will find the block using the filter conv. You can see that it seems that there are no blocks containing conv in the name, but in the reality there is at least one. In fact, the system shows a library. We don't see the blocks because the library is collapsed. So we have simply to expand, just double click. So there are five blocks. What we need is the conv real, because we will manage real variables. As usual, drag and drop. After that, we have to place blocks for managing the compressors. The block is called hysteresis. So let's filter by hist. There is a block in the standard, hyster, and two blocks in the Karel Basic Lib. The block that we have to use is hyster advanced real, this one, because also in this case we have to manage real variables. We have four compressor, so four of this block. I quickly copy with the control move, and then connect. Well, now we can create the variables. water in the temperature, set point, proportional band, compressor 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's open the global variables. We will remove the two variables I had created before, then add a new variable. The name is water inlet temperature. Tab to move to the next cell. It is a real. You can of course select the variables also from the list. And I will give also a description. And then I create set point temperature. Real also this one. The third is proportional band temperature, real. For the last two variables, I select also the flag retain to save them in the what in Montool is called the permanent memory. So in case of a blackout, the value is not lost. The next variables are the ones for the compressor. So I create compressor 1, boolean is good. To create the other three variables, we can use another very convenient function, that is the quick declaration. Just right click somewhere here in the background, quick declaration. We can start from 2, because the variable 1 has been already created. 1 to 4, the prefix is comp for compressor, data type boolean is good, and here below we don't see, but there is a preview of the variables we are creating. I can't see it because in this moment the resolution of the screen is very low and the system for some reason cuts the bottom part of the window. Anyway, now I will press OK, and here are the variables compressor 1, 2, 3, 4. I have only to add the description. Okay, now we can place the variable in the page. To place variables, we have to use a new object called variable. It is in the toolbox window. As usual, if you don't have it, you have to go in the window, in the view, and toolbox, here is. So you have to drag and drop. Here is the variable, so select the variable. This, we start with the, from this, double click, and here is water inlet temperature. Okay, let's continue with the others. So another variable, set point temperature. Another way is right click at the background, insert variable, as well as control 1 shortcut. Also then temperature. So the regulation temperature is water in the temperature, and the limit of the ramp are set point and set point plus the proportional band. So regulation value is water in the temperature. The beginning of the ramp is set point, and the end is set point plus the proportional band. So we have to add a addition block. In this tool is called plus, not add like one tool. So set point plus the proportional band. Okay, we can resize the width of the variable object, but just to have the sort of alignment of the object is not important. In the other side, we can place the variable representing the status of the compressor. So, variable compressor 1. Connect control move to clone. This is you can see that this is another way to select the variable. It is click the variable object, move the cursor a little bit up in order to select the variable. Then click it, the system shows the list of all the variables you have created. And so just select another one. Okay, and then for compressor 3, compressor 4. Click compressor 3, compressor 4. Now we have to set the position of the stages in the proportional band. Probably you notice that there is only one block regarding the stages, not one specific for the direct stages and one for the reverse stages, only one. In this case there is a pin that is able to reverse the logic of the stage. Then there is a set point and a differential left and a differential right. Differential left and right are independent from the reverse. So left is always the value at the left side of the set point, and right on the right side. In our case, regarding the compressor number one and the stage number one, we have two options. We could set set point 0, differential left 0 and differential right 25%, or set point 25, differential left 25 and differential right 0. I prefer the second one. So we have to connect a constant 25 to the set point. So how to create a constant? We have to use the same object we use for the variable, that is the variable object. Just type a number rather than select a variable in this list. So 25, ok. Another variable, this is a differential left, so 25 also this one. Variable differential right is 0. And reverse is 0 to have a direct stage and 1 to have a reverse stage. In this case we need of a direct, so I will place another constant 0. Okay, now I will copy this value to the second, third, fourth stage. So the set point of the stage 1 is 25%, second 50, 75, 100. So for the first stage, first compressor, set point 25, for the second is 50, third is 75, and for the last is 100%. Well, the strategy is quite finished. Now we can compile, but in this system it's not called compile the procedure, but build. So there is a specific menu for build, but you can find the same function also in the toolbar here, the build, and as well as here. So build. The system opens the output window and shows some information, and there are a lot of errors. 25, 25, 00, expecting real type. What is the problem here? The problem is that in the standard IC 61131, the real variable, the real constant, requires the dot. Like in this case, even if the decimal value is 0. So we don't have to write 25, 25 also here in 0, but 25.0 also here 25.0 and here 0.0, and the same for the other stages. Now I try to build again, but there are still errors expecting boolean type here and also here and the other. Why? For more or less the same problem of before, that is the boolean constant or literals for boolean are true and false for 1 and 0. So I have to replace 0 with false, and the same for other three. Okay, and then build again. Okay, build succeeded. And that's all regarding the strategy. Maybe that you are wondering, okay, but the block to read the physical analog input and write the digital output, well, in this tool those functions are not here in the strategy, but they are in another editor, is a C-Design, but this is matter of another exercise. So that's all for this exercise. Next step is the simulation, but we will see how to do it in the next video.